Hi, my name is Marcus Huskins, and thank you for joining me. And in this video, we're going to be taking a look at using the Audio Suite Quick APT plugin when using Revoice Pro with Pro Tools. So in a different video, we had a detailed look at using the Revoice Pro Link plugin to get our audio sent over from Pro Tools into Revoice Pro and then back into the Pro Tools timeline. Now let's take a moment to talk about the Revoice Pro Quick APT plugin. In certain cases, you may find that you just need to create a really quick APT that, for example, could impart the timing and pitch of our lead vocal. This is where the Quick APT plugin really shines. So let's go ahead. I'm going to select this audio over here. And the next thing I want to do is make sure that Revoice Pro is active. Now for my Audio Suite menu, I'm going to head over to Synchro Arts and we can choose Revoice Pro APT. And if you're not seeing these categories, you'll be able to find it in Other and again, Revoice Pro APT. All right, so the idea with this particular plugin is you want to send over your guide track and then send over your dub track, that is the track that you want to fix, and then spot it back into your Pro Tools timeline very quickly. Now, one thing I want to point out here is this auto switch option. If you are just processing one APT at a time, you're going to want to make sure that this auto switch option is engaged. So with our guide track selected and capture guide, I'm going to go ahead and click the capture option. Now, if we were to go ahead and resize our Pro Tools screen over here, you can see that we have a Revoice Pro document where the guide track has been transferred over. You'll also notice that this plugin automatically switched over to Capture Dub. So if I click into my Pro Tools screen now, and I was to, for example, use my semicolon key to select the audio clips on this track, now we go ahead and capture this. Revoice Pro has automatically created that APT for us. If we head into the Revoice Pro screen, click the E key, we can listen back to those results.
My heart is an ocean. Nothing can save it. Nothing at all.
Okay, just as a reminder to the way this started off.
My heart is an ocean. Nothing can save it. Nothing at all.
So now the idea is that once you've got this done, you want to get this audio, this output track, sent back into our Pro Tools timeline. Now this is very simple. Essentially all we need to do is click the spot key. Now this has been spotted back over, and if I were to play both of these tracks in Pro Tools against each other.
My heart is an ocean, nothing can save it, nothing at all.
So that's it, a really, really quick way that we can get our audio sent over, processed, and brought back into Pro Tools without any fuss. And when you have this auto switch option enabled, which automatically selects the capture dub after the guide has been captured, it really helps make this a seamless workflow. Now let's talk about a couple other things. You may be asking, what settings is Revoice Pro using to create that APT? Well, this is pretty simple. If we were to go ahead and select a Revoice Pro screen, and I was to open up the parameters for this particular process, if we head over here and I go to Factory Presets and Music, Slightly Loose Pitch and Time, you'll notice that I can go in here and save as User Default Preset. Now, the way that the Audio Suite Quick APT plugin works is that it will use whatever you have defined as your user default preset. So in this case, where I have just gone ahead and defined that my user default preset is Music Slightly Loose Pitch and Time, that is what will be used to create your APTs. Now, a couple things to note on this is that if you are using this in a post-production workflow, you might want to consider changing this over. So for example, if you had this set for working with music and it had used the Music Slightly Loose Pitch and Time, we could, for example, come over here, again, open up our parameters by clicking the P key, and we could choose something that's a little bit more relevant to a post-production workflow, something like tight timing only. Now from there, I could come here and I could update my user default preset. Now if I was using the Quick APT plugin in a post-production workflow, it would be using that. In this case though, let's go ahead and leave this set to Music Slightly Loose Pitch and Time and make sure that we save this as our user default preset. Now, another thing to point out is that the workflow that we've used, although that it works really good for doing quick APTs, if you need to work in stacks where you have, for example, multiple different processes that you want to work with, we have another thing that we need to consider. So let's go ahead here. I'm just going to close this off for a moment, and let's have a look at creating stacks using the Quick APT plugin. Now, when working with vocal stacks, one thing that we have to consider is that most likely we will still be wanting to use the same guide for everything. So let's go ahead. We will select this audio clip again here, and I'm going to go to my SyncroArts category, and we're going to bring up the Revoice Pro APT Audio Suite plugin. Now, I'm going to go ahead and leave this set as is for now, but we're going to take a look at one important adjustment that we need to make in a moment. So let's go ahead. We will capture our guide track. And now if I was to go ahead and bring in Revoice Pro, you'll see that our guide has been captured. And let's go ahead and resize our Pro Tool screen so that we can see things a little bit better. Now, next up, I can go ahead here and make a selection. This is automatically switched. Let's go ahead and capture our dub. We'll go ahead and click this capture, and you can see here that Revoice Pro has created that output for us. Let me go ahead and give this a quick play. Keep in mind, this was created using the user-defined preset. And we'll go ahead and click the E key to have a listen.
My heart is an ocean. Nothing can save it. Nothing at all.
So that works for me. So let's go ahead and we want to spot this back in. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to deselect the auto switch option. So let's go ahead and spot this back. And now we've rendered this file in our Pro Tools timeline. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and select this clip. And this time, since we already have our guide track that's been sent over, let's just click capture. And this is going to recapture our dub. And now Revoice Pro has gone ahead and it's processed my lead vox double 2 file over here to match. Now this is simply a matter of clicking the spot over here, and we've just time aligned both of these. Let's have a really quick listen to these.
My heart is an ocean. Nothing can save it. Nothing at all. So twisted and broken, lost in the storm.
So that's using the Revoice Pro Quick APT Audio Suite AAX plugin in Pro Tools. We'll catch you in the next video.